So we're gonna ask now. You're actually a part of this, right?
Yes.
Okay. We're gonna ask him exactly how does he feel? How has he taken this a blow? Like if he feels sad or just more with more energy to keep on fighting?
It is unfortunate that we aren't able to resist this eviction this time, but I'm optimistic because a lot of us for the last few months have been planning ahead that we do need more than one location that we can consider. Places that we are occupying or places that are supporters of us. So we are actually, this is definitely not a giant blow because we are able to organize in other locations. Some people are going to be camping a few blocks away from what I understand. And some of us also meet at homes of foreclosure victims that we've been helping with their foreclosure issues and that sort of thing. And I think that ultimately that's the way forward, especially in South Florida, that we're going to be building support in communities by helping them with their foreclosure problems and not just occupying centralized downtown areas, but occupying the communities themselves that are being affected by the 1%, I guess you'd say.
Okay, thanks. And what's your name, by the way?
My name's Nathan Pym.
And one last question. Do you think that it's like the movement initially when it started, like with the parading, when they took to the streets, I saw more variety in the element that consisted it. Do you feel that maybe the labor's been lost in attracting a certain part of society, or do you feel that it's still open? Like so the support for people, do you feel that people have been supporting you?
Well, I think there is broad support for Occupy. The occupation of downtown areas is really specific to a certain problem we're facing, which is homelessness. Generally, people aren't going to be fighting militarism or environmental problems by camping out downtown. I think whether people realize it or not, that occupying in a downtown area is a homeless issue, and there are people who are going to be continuing to work on homeless issues, but I think especially with this happening that we are going to see the blocks of Occupy that are working on different issues are going to have time to flex their muscles and show what they're capable of, and we are going to see that support is still there and that we are still going to have larger events where people are going to come together, but that it was a problem that we focused on these homeless occupations, and that we are, I hope this allows us to refocus on the larger movement building where we are appealing to all the different issues, and that we'll get to that now that this is happening.
And okay, one last question. My opinion is that since the beginning, I noticed that there wasn't there weren't any leaders, people who actually took, I know that sometimes, it can go bad in that direction. You don't want a tyrant taking over the group, but do you feel that maybe the movement has been led astray because it's like a mass without a head, or like you for yourself? I mean, would you have liked to maybe steer this boat?
No, I would disagree with that. I along with other people have played our parts in steering things in certain directions, but I think that having leadership in these movements is actually a fault that we've seen. We saw that the Tea Party, which gathered for much the same reasons, gathered up elected officials and leadership and almost instantly betrayed their base, and now they're just more congressmen in office that are ignoring the will of the people. I'm part of another group called Food Not Bombs I've been doing for some time. Food Not Bombs is a 30-year-old group that has stayed as strong as it's ever been, in part because it is another leaderless movement, and that having a leaderless movement is the best way to keep it from people being able to take control of it, so that we don't become the Democratic Tea Party in the future, or we don't get taken over by, say, the guys in Oakland that want to smash stuff all the time. I think that mostly keeping a leaderless, directly democratic movement is the way that we have to confront the power in our nation today.
How long are you willing to stay? Do you see this as a movement that will just take years, or is it slowly dying?
I would say I can't predict the future on that. Whether Occupy stays or dies, there is another group that will take its place. Just as we saw with the Tea Party became ineffective. Occupy Wall Street came. If Occupy Wall Street fizzles, there'll be another group. As long as the injustice in America, the rampant foreclosure abuse, the militarism continues, that if Occupy fizzles, there's just going to be another thing that's going to look pretty much like it. Just maybe there'll be a little, if anything, if this peaceful movement doesn't get their way, we could see other movements that are you know, taken to more extreme means for that. So I hope we do. I hope we do continue, and that we do see success with us before it gets too much worse.
Right. I mean, the thing is that we can't expect that everything's just gets erased because the solution hasn't been brought to the light. We haven't seen any actual laws or anything. There hasn't been an improvement of anything. So if the problem persists, if there's still a serious preoccupation here, like just removing these people isn't going to solve anything, because you're just changing position. The problems are still there, and somebody is going to have to face them sooner or later. Thank you so much.
Sure thing. You're welcome.
Okay.
Thank you.